As a young campus student, how often were you told you're a grown-up and that you can fend for yourself? How often are the ones telling you this your parents? Well, I'm here to share with you a life story filled with, how can I put it, disappointment, depression, a journey of growth and self-acceptance. This is a self-love initiative, a project by Ghost Animations. As a high school student, I tended to enjoy life, never taking my education seriously in the name of my parents. You know, my parents were really rich. I don't have to try that much. Hence, my grades weren't all that good. Luckily, I attained a grade that made me eligible for university, but I had not qualified for regular admission. So my parents had to cater for my tuition fee as well as my accommodation for the 4 years. In class, I got to meet different people from different backgrounds. People who really struggled, you know? I remember this particular guy. His name is Mac. You know, let's talk about Mac for a minute. Mac was an orphan. And he was in campus. Well, it's not odd to find orphans in campus, but Mark told me about his struggle, about how everything was taken from him after his parents died. Mark told me about his education. Mark told me about his journey. This actually raised my eyebrows in the sense that I was very fortunate than others, and that I should show some gratitude for having to be there. So this is what I decided to do. I decided to make up for all the bad grades, you know? All the bad grades I had in high school, I changed my attitude. I wanted to make my parents proud, you know? The first 3 years were a joy for me because I had become an A student, you know, destined for big things. Like some would say, I was at a happy place. Little did I know things wouldn't always be the same. It was one of the long holidays, one of those weekends. I was chilling in my room. I can actually remember the specific music I was listening to. Nicki Minaj. My mom came to me in my room with a sad face and told me, I can't remember her specific words, but this is how I'll put it. She said, I need to talk to you. And I just looked at her and thought, okay, this might be serious. And she said, we're not able to pay for your tuition fee anymore. And we're really sorry. We have to look after your younger siblings. And the specific words she put it like this, you're a bright boy. You can find your way out there. There's so many opportunities out there. And I was just staring at her. Those words crushed me. I mean, these are my parents. And they don't want to fend for me anymore. How selfish can they be? Who should I turn to? Little did I know, my dad had lost his job. And he was drowning in debt. But that didn't stop me from hating them. I hated them so much. I wondered, how could my parents do this to me? I mean, looking back, you know, I was young. How could I have understood, right? How could I have understood? I later became bitter, isolating myself whenever I'm at home. I started hanging out with the wrong crowd just to piss my parents off. I started doing drugs. I became violent. It was such a dark time for me. At times I would lose sleep in the middle of the night. I remember feeling it. How can I put it? I remember feeling bitterness, hatred. I hated everything. I hated everything. Everything that moved, walked, everything that talked, I hated everything. Little did I know I was falling into depression. This went on for a few months. It started off as days, weeks, months, until I started having suicidal thoughts. You know, I would justify these thoughts in the name of what was there to live for. I felt like I had lost everything. And just like any other parent, my mom saw this and decided that this we have to do something, and so called me. And they had to explain the situation. And this is how they put it. It doesn't mean that we don't love you. And we are always there for emotional support. I had carried for months. And I did. I remember crying throughout the conversation. And to my surprise, I felt whole again. I wasn't bitter anymore. You know, this is what I decided to do. I decided to cultivate my own happiness and channel all my energy to bettering myself. And to this day, I have never, ever had suicidal thoughts or any negative thoughts. I chose to embrace who I was and to accept the situation I am in. This is a story with a happy ending. Currently, I am alive, I am healthy, and that's all that matters anyway. And currently, I am at a job that I love. And you know what? I'm happy. I am really happy. So this is what I would say to you, to everyone who feels like no one really cares about them or thinks about them. I've got to say this to you. You're wrong. You're never alone. And whenever you feel like giving up, just find someone. Find someone and talk to. Just let it all out. It works like magic, trust me. You'll become a better person. I'm a better person. That was a true story that happened to one of my friends. He was brave enough to share his story. We're all going through such life-defining situations. The question is, are you willing to share your story? This has been Zuhura Kinyanju with the Self-Love Initiative. Catch us next time for another captivating story.